What's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? What's up, guys? Andrew Acevedo here, back with another video, and we are back with another New York Mets signing. And if you guys see, we are in a new location. We are finally in my new house. I'm sorry if there's a massive echo. I'm going to try to speak directly into the mic here. Obviously, we just moved in. I don't have everything. As you can see, there's some of my Mets memorabilia just to throw in the background. But finally, the Mets have made a move. After a very disappointing last couple days, not being able to land, not being outbid by the Mariners for James Paxton, not going out and signing a couple of relievers like Gismo Petit and Sergio Romo going to Oakland. Ken Giles went to the Mariners as well. So the relievers, since the Seth Lugo news, which I guess I can talk about Seth Lugo news, Seth's going to be out probably until May. I'd say maybe end of May we'll see Seth. And of course, it's just bad timing because the Mets bullpen was already questionable with Lugo in it. Now you take Lugo out until probably end of May. So, you know, he's not going to be able to throw until opening day pretty much. Now he's got to be able to build his arm back up. And he's going to be out for a little while. So now you have him out. And now the Mets, they need to get some pitching. Hopefully there's more pitching to come. And Zach Scott also had a press conference. Well, the last time I talked to you guys, Zach Scott had a press conference and said the Mets weren't done. And obviously they are not done, but they need to improve in the bullpen and in starting pitching. A couple rumors have come out. Maybe we'll talk about that after the signings that they actually did make. So we'll start with the little ones. Tommy Hunter from the formerly of the Philadelphia Phillies bullpen. They signed him and Mark Montgomery, left-handed reliever starter from the Cubs. Again, more depth, minor league deals, spring training invites. Tommy Hunter throws hard. He's like in the 99th percentile of fastball velocity. Was pretty decent. Throws a lot of cutters and fastballs. So it's a good move, Mike Montgomery. Left. Never a bad thing to have enough lefties. You add Mark Montgomery. Pretty solid. All right, now I guess to the bigger signing, which I've wanted since the beginning of the offseason, but I thought since the Albert Almora signing, he would not be a New York Met. And that is Kevin Pillar has now agreed to a one-year deal with the New York Mets. I think it was John Heyman that put it out first. He put out that they were in deep discussions, and now about 20 minutes later, it is now official. The Mets have agreed to term with a one-year deal with outfielder Kevin Pillar, source is confirmed. And then this is from Anthony DiComo. Pillar's defensive metrics in center field has slid in recent seasons, but historically strong defender coming off his best offensive season, slashing .288, .330 on base, and a .462 slugging, 6 homers, and 54 RBIs. Heyman believes was first mentioned that the Mets and Pillar were close. I've seen a couple people say, why now? Why do we need Pillar after we signed Almora? I think this could be two things. One, could be another bench piece. Could be a really good bench piece. Platoon with Nimmo in center field as the lefty killer, because he actually hit really well against lefties. I wish I could pull up his slash versus left-handed pitching, because he actually hits lefties historically pretty well. And Nimmo can be the right-handed plays against righties. Pillar can play against lefties. Almora has minor league option. I think he also put out that now the Mets have Martinez and Almora on the bench. They both have minor league. Martinez is a split contract where he's not a guaranteed major leaguer, and Almora does have minor league options. So now Pillar can come in, and he's on a major league deal. So we'll see what the Mets do in center field. Also, I think it was Joel Sherman said that Jackie Bradley Jr. could be in play for the Mets if the DH was coming. So maybe do the Mets make this, having some hindsight, and maybe the DH is going to come this year. I'm probably saying it's not going to come, but potentially maybe the DH does come to the National League, and this is what the Mets preparing, so they can shift Nimmo to left and have Pillar or Almora in center field. So again, it's a good signing. Actually, if you watched my Mets offseason video, which go back, it's on the channel, Mets dream offseason. The Mets have done a lot in that video in real life. Obviously, trading for Lindor. I had it being Zach Plesac with Lindor and a pitcher. I had a Zach Plesac, but I did mention Carlos Carrasco. Obviously, Kevin Pillar and Trevor May in the bullpen. So they made some moves. Obviously, they didn't sign Springer or Brad Hand, but you know, pretty solid. They've watched most of my video and most of the stuff I've said that I would do, the Mets have done. So it's a good deal for the Mets. They add some more depth. I would like them to bring in some rumors today that they have been heavily in talks with Trevor Rosenthal, which they should be now. That Seth Lugo is now going to be out until May. The Mets need another arm. They need one more to begin with before Lugo getting injured. Now Lugo is out of the mix. Yeah, Trevor Rosenthal would be nice. And also, in the starting rotation mark, I would like one more starter in the rotation. And they've been in talk with Taijuan Walker. He supposedly wants a multi-year deal, $10 million per. I mean, that's a pretty solid. If it's like $10 to $11 million for 2 years, $22 million over 2 years, I'm fine with that. Again, he's high upside. He's 28 years old. He's younger than guys like Jacob DeRizzi, who was still on the block. Obviously, now Paxton is off the market. And now Arrieta, who was one of the higher reported from Martino, guys that the Mets were interested in. Now they're both, and Rich Hill is off the book, so I'm hoping now the Mets will pivot to Taijuan Walker. I think he could be a really good number 3-4 starter before Syndergaard comes in. And I mean, you can put him in the bullpen. He's flexible, and hopefully he still has some upside coming his way. So leave me in the comment section down below, where do you think Kevin Pillar fits in with the Mets? Obviously, if you want to talk about the minor league deals for Hunter and Montgomery, you talk about it. And how big is that Seth Lugo injury going to hurt the Mets? And which reliever or relievers would you like the Mets to sign? For me, I'd go get the best two available. That's Shane Green, and that's obviously Trevor Rosenthal. They just lost Justin Wilson to a minor league deal to the Yankees. Signing Pillar doesn't make me feel better about that, but at least they did go out and improve the team some more. They still need some pitching. They got to add some bullpen arms. They got to add another starter in the rotation. We'll see what Zach Scott and Sandy have in mind. Hopefully they can get some pitching in here. Like Zach Scott said, you can never have enough pitching. Well, we don't have enough pitching. We need some pitching. So we'll see what he does in the next couple days. Obviously now we are in the new house, so videos can come out a lot more content coming. Obviously probably not until March, I would say. The content's really going to pick up. But I think after next, we still officially don't have Wi-Fi, so I'm going to, you know, upload this via service. But next week we get Wi-Fi set up, so we're going to be pumping out content. Ungodly amount of content. Spring training hits, and I can't wait to get started. So leave me in the comment section down below, what do you guys think? Here's a little update on the channel. The setup is coming. We're gonna have maybe a room tour. You guys saw a tease of what my collection could be. Obviously you guys have not seen it all. Maybe a room tour is coming once I get that done. So thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Make sure to turn the notification bell on, so you never miss any New York Mets news. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.